Well, the warmer weather marks a return of dirt bikes and ATVs to the streets of Boston.
Critics say they're a dangerous nuisance, while others call them a much-needed outlet for the city's young people. 5 Investigates Mike Baudette is tracking the tension and a search for solutions.
I still don't know how I survived.
This elderly man attacked after a group of dirt bike and ATV riders surrounded his car last November.
Came back with a pipe in his hand, smashed my hood, smashed my windshield, and then started beating me.
A group of people on motorcycles, dirt bikes, attacking somebody in a red Honda.
This fight in Dorchester just last month, shining another spotlight on the issue.
Our camera caught several weaving through traffic and running the red light near Franklin Park.
They're out there kind of just to wreak havoc.
Boston Police Deputy Superintendent Lanita Cullinane says many of the vehicles are stolen and not registered. The auto theft unit seized around 50 stolen dirt bikes and ATVs from a self-storage facility in Roslindale in February. One in a string of confiscations over the last several years.
We've devised a strategic approach that we've implemented, and it includes, but it's not limited to, civil motor vehicle infractions, court complaints for misdemeanor motor vehicle violations.
5 Investigates obtained hundreds of pages of police reports about dirt bikes and ATVs that paint an ugly picture of the problem. Police describe the city being plagued by offenders riding off-highway vehicles, often forming smaller packs or larger groups of more than 60 riders known as a rideout, that people have felt terrorized and made to feel unsafe, that they're involved in uninsured motor vehicle accidents, hit-and-run incidents, as well as collisions with pedestrians, and that the vehicles have been used in armed robberies, carjacking, shootings, and homicides.
And one of the things that they look to do is engage the police in pursuits.
But Boston police will not chase after dirt bikes and ATVs. They say it's too risky.
We're just trying to do what we can within the confines of the law to deal with the situation, but not increase the safety risks in terms of pursuits and things of that nature.
How concerned are you about these vehicles on our roads?
We want to make sure that this summer is one that is safe and exciting and joyful for everyone.
We caught up with Boston's mayor, who says it's not fair to assume everyone riding dirt bikes and ATVs is involved in illegal activity.
It seems like it's a safety concern.
I want to separate out what is safety and actions that should never happen in any situation, like any sort of violence that is being perpetuated, versus the general idea of some of our young people enjoying having the chance to ride and to learn a new skill and be part of a community there.
I think it's a problem.
People we talk to in the city say it's a balancing act.
I'm not saying get rid of them all, you know, together, but just be cautious.
I don't disagree with the cycles. I totally think there should be some protocols for them to be able to use so they don't get hurt.
Boston police have adjusted traffic patterns to try and divert riders away from certain areas where they congregate. They're also working on a new city ordinance that would give them additional tools, but did not reveal any details. Mike Baudette, 5 Investigates.